Hello everyone. So this is the first video of well-logging series, and in this series I am going to discuss all the logs in a detailed version. This video is going to be very very beneficial for your examination or even in your semester examinations. If you have not studied the book, not for even once, and you are directly watching this video, still this video is going to be very very relevant for you. But if you have at least once you have studied the book and then you are watching, then it's going to be very very important, because now you will have very good concept build up. So let's get started. I just want from you guys to do comment what you like, what you don't like, what you have understand, what you have don't understand. Comment, we will discuss everything. Okay, so the first thing which comes in my mind is not in just my mind and everyone minds, what is well-log? So in all industry, what happens is that a recording against depth of any of the raw characteristics. That raw characteristics can be density, it can be velocity, it can be porosity, anything. So that raw characteristics of the raw formation against depth that is traversed by a measuring apparatus in a well bore is a log. Basically, it's a recording against depth of any of the characteristics of the rock which is traversed by a measuring apparatus, logging tool basically. So and well log is also called wire line logs, and these are obtained by means of measuring equipment, which is logging tool, and that is lowered by a cable into the well. Now okay, so the measurement are transmitted to the cable several conductors to the surface laboratory or computer unit. And one thing you should know that these wire line logs are performed after the termination of drilling activity. Wireline logs are different from measurement while drilling, MWD, or logging while drilling. Wireline logs and logging while drilling are different things. We will discuss it later more. Right now, wireline logs are performed after the termination of drilling activity. So they are different from drilling logs or mud logs, which are obtained during drilling. Okay. And so basically what we know from the wireline response, the characteristics of the formation, what is the resistivity of the formation, what is the density, what is the sonic velocity, all these things will be discussed later, and do not hesitate. Okay, so the resistivity log, if I give you example, the resistivity log is a continuous plot of formation's resistivity. What is formation? Basically a rock formation up to a horizon from the bottom of the well to the top, and it may represent over 4 kilometers of the readings. And electrical log was the first log that was derived by Schlumberger, and it is also called electrical coring. So the geophysical measurement can be of two types. It can be spontaneous, for example natural radioactivity, where we are directly detecting the gamma rays, natural radioactivity. It can be also induced, for example sonic log, density log, where we are giving the radiation and then we are measuring how that formation is behaving with the radiation, how this formation is reacting with the radiation. We will measure that, we will discuss it more later. So induced and formation velocity logs. So what we do is sonic log. Basically a tool emits a sound in the formation and measure the time taken for the sound to reach a receiver at a set distance along the tool. Okay, how much time the sound take to reach the receiver, which is a set distance from the detector, we will measure that time, that is in microsecond per tool we measure that. Okay, there is a thing which we commonly know, cuttings or corings. What are these things? These are the fragment of rock flushed to the surface during the drilling.
So what is cuttings? Is basically the fragment of rock flushed to the surface during drilling, and these are the principal source of subsurface sampling. Okay, so what happens that if I talk about this corings and cuttings, do we get all the information from that? No. What happens that it doesn't give the good image of the geological subsurface. For example, if you want to know what is the where is the potential reservoir is located, and if it is located, does it have hydrocarbons or not, and what are the presence of nearby reservoir, all this information you will not get it from subsurface corings. So a detailed analysis is required, and that is what we do well logging. So what happens is that, so a very effective way to approach this problem is to take situ measurements, that means on-site measurements, by running well logs. And logs tells us about the fluids in the pores, like it's water or oil or gas, whatever it is. We will get to get this information from logging. We cannot get this information from subsurface corings. If someone asks you why this subsurface coring doesn't give you all the information, you can answer this now. Okay. So any change in the log response is indicated a change in at least one of the geological parameters. For example, if the fluid changes, for if water nearby water, then it changes to hydrocarbon, there will be at least one change in the geological parameter. For example, resistivity might change, density might change, velocity might change, all these things, at least one will change definitely, and we will get it from well log responses. Okay. Bare line geophysical well logs are recorded when the drilling tools are no longer in the hole. As I've already told you, they are done after drilling process is ceased. Now, what is open hole log? Open hole log indicates that the formation forms the wall of the well. Like formation is basically the wall. There is no casing. No, there we will discuss it later. What is casing? Like there is formation which directly forms the wall of the well. But if I talk about cased hole, in which a tube of metal casing lines the well, or concrete lining has been inserted to stabilize the well bore. Now, what is casing? Casing basically there is a well, and to stabilize the formation so that the formation doesn't collapse into the well bore, or it doesn't cave into the well bore. So to stabilize that, we do casing. We will discuss it later more, but right now you know that. What is casing? Basically to stabilize the formation, and so the formation does not cave into the well bore, or the formation fluid does not escape into the well bore. So we do casing, but there are benefits and also disadvantage of casings. We will discuss it later. Okay. Now, as you know, measurement while drilling and logging while drilling are by contrast made as formation is drilled. Matlab, like directly, if you are drilling right now in at the time drilling, we are also taking measurements. That is different from wireline logs. And most logs, there is an important point you should remember. Most logs are run while putting the tool up from the bottom to the hole. But there is the exception of temperature log. What we do here, which is must be run on the way into the borehole, because its present into the hole disturbs the temperature reading. All the logs which we take measurement, we take by pulling the tool up. But in case of temperature log, when we are going down to the well, the temperature, the readings are taken, because there is a disturbance of the formation. And how this disturbance occurs, we will discuss in temperature log. But right now you should understand, when we are going down to the well, at that time we are taking the measurements. While in other logs, we will take measurement by putting the tool up. Okay. Logging while tools are designed to connect into drill string and communicate data to the surface through drilling mud. Okay, these things. Okay. Now, so sometimes what happens that the gamma ray sensor is not at the same depth as the resistivity sensor, because what we do, we take a tool and there are two three measurement units are there. There is a gamma ray detector, there is also resistivity detector. So we are taking measurement at some different depth at the same time. So what happens that, so at any one instant different formation are being sampled. The surface computer memorizes readings and compensate for depth or time lag and gives a depth matching point. Sometimes also this is a good use of gamma ray log, that it can be helpful for a depth matching point. All things will be discussed later. Do not get panic. This is our introduction video, but I will give you some touch of the, like, what is well log, all those things, and when we go for log to log, then we will discuss in detail all the things. The quality of data from the rock is best from open hole logs. It's quite obvious. If the formation is directly the wall, we will get good information about the formation, about the resolution, analysis, everything. But if there is a casing between the formation, definitely casing will affect, and we will not get good as good as information as we get from open hole logs. Okay, so sometimes in books it's not so important, but you should know that logging while measurement and measurement while drilling, these terms are differently used, like they are not used as the same thing. Measurement while drilling is generally taken to refer drilling type measurements such as hole deviation or mud related information, while logging while drilling is taken to refer log type measurements such as resistivity, density, velocity, etc. Okay, logging while drilling log types are similar to wireline logs, but not identical. Let me tell you this how it happens. For example, a gamma ray logging while tool is comparable to wireline log gamma ray log, and LWD resistivity log is comparable to shallow resistivity log. So what happens that is the logging while drilling, these are logs are used in highly deviated wells, like the common measuring equipment cannot go directly into the well. So in that case we will use logging while drilling measurements, and in that case this is going to be beneficial as compared to the conventional wireline logs. The same thing is written here. Logging while drilling tools are used in highly deviated and horizontal wells, where they help to direct the drilling, and function condition is very difficult for standard wireline tools. Okay, so log derived information of porosity derived from zoning or density, water saturation calculated from porosity and electrical logs, etc. Okay, so wireline logs are made when the drill bit is removed from the borehole, and this can either be between drilling episodes, before casing is laid, or end of the drilling. As I've already told you, wireline logs are done after the drilling is ceased or before the casing is loaded, in between, before that. So
this is a log. You can see this is basically a resistivity log, and how this resistivity changes through the depth. At some point it is low, and at some point it is high. You can see that, and why it is high, we will discuss all those things. Many of you may know why it is high, but we will discuss it later and discuss all those things. So in this video, I've discussed giving you some introduction about well logging. Next video we will discuss more things, and stay tuned. If you have questions, if you don't understand anything, please comment so that we can discuss. Thank you.